Hey guys, Steel Pot here, and today I'm going to be talking about how to properly use the M17 gas mask. Starting off with the most common place for it to be worn, the M17 gas mask bag had two straps. One of them was thicker and was meant to go around the waist, straddling the bag around the left side, always the left. And there was a secondary strap that could either be put around the left leg, or you also see some shoulders just wrapping it around the bag itself. It was on the left side, so soldiers could easily access the flap and not have to scramble around the back. Another place for it to be worn, but not as commonly, is just around the shoulder with the strap either just hanging loose or wrapped around it, like I said earlier. This setup was mainly seen in Way City for Marines, when the gas masks were being used more prominently because of the use of tear gas. This makes it much more easier to access, and it's easier to run around without having to worry about it being on your leg. In the last spot you mainly see them, it's not so much the gas mask being used, but the bag. The Army didn't enforce the carrying of gas masks as much as the Marines, so when the Army did get them, they would usually just use the bags for personal items, and you would see these usually around on the back of the rucksack. Now, I'm going to show you how to actually put on the gas mask and use it. First thing you're going to want to do is make sure there's nothing that's on your face that could obstruct the gas mask from sealing all the way. So I'm going to take off my beanie. Sorry if my hair's a little messy. Then, you're just going to put the gas mask on. Make sure all the straps are tight. Then, you're going to press firmly to the sides and just blow as hard as you can to get the airflow through there. You'll know when you've got a good airflow, when your gas mask eye lenses aren't fogging up as much, and when you can hear that noticeable push of air coming through. So then now you should be able just to breathe normally through your gas mask. Next, we're gonna talk about the features of the gas mask and what's in the bag. Now, I'm just going to tell you ahead of time right now, I am missing one thing. That is the waterproof bag for the mask. That would go in this side pocket right here that you can see. But what would go in there is just a waterproof bag. So, you have two of these type of push buttons. And now, you take, the mask comes out like that. It fits very nicely. As you can see, this is a size medium. I'm just going to show you the label. So, this is an M17. This is what you're gonna want for Vietnam, or if you're doing late war, a grasshopper gas mask. That's a little bit more slanted and smaller, and that comes in an entirely different case. But the M17A1s came with a drinking tube that kind of came along the front right there that could be attached to a canteen to drink while you had your gas mask on. From what I know, those were never used in Vietnam. I read somewhere that they started production in 1966, but I'm not sure if they ever saw any use in Vietnam. So, you'll know if it's correct if it has this flat front. Mine is dated 1963. You can see the 63 right there. That's the easiest way to tell the date. The bags did not come with a date, just the masks. It's got two lenses right there. It tells you US and size, medium. And the straps adjust very easily just by pulling like that. And there's the strap system. So there's the mask. Next up in the bag are some lenses. You can pop these over the top of the lenses. I'll show you how to do that later. And they're like basically outserts that you can pop onto your gas mask. The last thing I have in here is an anti-dim cloth. What you can do with this is you can dampen it a little bit, wipe the inside of your lens, and it won't fog up as much, I guess. So I will show you how to do all of those things right now. All right, guys, now I'm going to show you how to put on the lenses. So reading the instructions that are on the bag itself, what you're gonna wanna do is roll the rubber part back like this. If you don't do this step, it'll be pretty hard to put them on. You're gonna line it up there, push down, and then you're just gonna roll the rubber back. And there it goes. It's attached all the way. Simple as that. I'm just gonna put on the other one. So this, actually no, I'm gonna give you an example of what would happen if you didn't roll a rubber back first. What I tried to do the first time I did it was just kind of pull, and when you get to that point, the bottom, it just pops back off. So it's much easier. I'm gonna show you just again. Roll the rubber back. Position it, and just roll the rubber forward. And it looks pretty much about the same. The only difference is that it's a little bit clunkier, kind of bulges out more. But this is what it looks like with the lenses. They're officially called Outsert Eyelets M1 for the M17 Protective Field Mask. So they're outserts. So that's how you put on your outserts. When you're done using the outserts, you just pop them back in the bag and pop them back in the bigger bag. These are a closer look at the exact instructions that I follow to put on the eyelets or outserts. Now I'm going to show you guys how to use the anti-dim cloth if you have one. You're going to unscrew the lid just so that's ready. And the first thing you're going to want to do is you apply this after you're done using it, is wet your fingertips a little and then rub the inside of each lens, kind of dampening it a little bit. Just like that. Then you're gonna take the cloth out. I'm not gonna unroll it much since I kinda like to keep it rolled up. And you're just gonna rub that water in. And the instructions on the can specifically say to rub very vigorously. So you're gonna rub it pretty hard. All right, now the next one. And there you go. That is how you use an anti-dim cloth. All right, guys, that's the video. Hopefully it helped you out. Let me know in the comments if I missed anything. Check out my other videos, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.